Hey YouTubers, this is the cat down the road. This is a new page. I just started this channel. I've never done this before. I'm completely new to YouTube, so I'm assuming that I will get better as I go. Today on my first video, I'm just gonna introduce myself and kind of let you know who I am, and that way if you want to keep watching my videos, you can. If not, you don't have to. No pressure. This all started because of my guru, Ralph Smart. He is always talking in his videos about the cat down the road, and it just cracks me up every time I hear him say it. And so I was like, well, if Ralph can do it, and he always says that he wasn't sure when he started doing this if it was going to even be worth it, but look at him now. You know, he's doing really great. And what he does is he's a psychiatrist and he's a motivational speaker, and I call him my guru. Because he has helped me to really truly become the best me I could be, and I really wanted to thank him for that. I always listen to in the morning Sadhguru and Ralph Smart, and the reason is because I love perspectives. I love looking at the world through other people's perspectives. I love to learn. It's one of my favorite things to do. But about me, so that you get to know me a little bit, my name is Allie Cat, or Cat on the Road, or Allie, or whatever you want to call me. My mom calls me Al, so whatever. I am a mother of three kids. I do suffer from a mental disorder. I've been diagnosed with bipolar 2 disorder and schizoaffective tendencies. I take two medications. One for anxiety and panic disorder and one for bipolar disorder. I have been on my medications consecutively for I think 6 years now. And so I've been pretty stable minded. I'm not gonna lie to you, before I was on medication and before, like, when I called out for help, I literally screamed. Like, I had went to the doctor and found out I weighed 320 pounds. That night, I went home and I sat in my bedroom and cried. And I screamed out to God, if you are real, please send someone to help me. And the next day, my life changed. I got a phone call. I went to a doctor. I was seen by a doctor for free. I did choose to do inpatient treatment for, like, I think it was 2 weeks. For them to test medications to see what would work best for me. They put me on, Wellbutrin for my bipolar disorder and Valium for my, panic disorders. But that's basically it. Before this, I literally grew up going in and out at least once a year to a behavioral hospital of some sort. Because I have literally a chemical imbalance in my brain. I don't make enough dopamine and serotonin to keep my brain at a happy level. So this is all, like I said, this is all new to me, but I'm just telling you who I am and about what, you know, anything you want to know about me. I'm an open book, so feel free to ask. I have no secrets, and that has been my key to happiness in life, is having no secrets. From anyone, I will talk about anything, and anybody that knows me will tell you I'm crazy, because I'll just put it out there. You know, I'll call out the pink elephant in the room. I'm that weird friend, that cat down the road, you know? About 5 years ago or 6 years ago, I found myself in deep depression. I weighed 320 pounds. I wasn't being a very good parent. I wasn't being a very good person. I wasn't taking care of myself. I only took care of my children. Pretty much everything else, including myself, I neglected. But I wasn't happy. I knew that I should clean my house every day as a mom. I knew I should do laundry every day, but I wasn't doing them, and I didn't know why. So I called out for help. I got to these doctors. I got the help I needed. I started on medications, and then this continued on. My life continued to get better. And I don't go to church. I'm not really religious. I'm not part of any kind of religious group of any sort at all. But all I did was just talk to God. Like, I was just like, you know, every single day I would wake up and I would just be like, okay, God, you know, what can I do today? What can I do to make the world a better place today? You know, for you, for me, for all of us. And little tiny things would happen, and it, things that blew my mind, to be honest with you, because there were moments where I thought, had this been 10 seconds later, this entire situation never would have taken place, and I would not have the blessings that I've been given, and I would not have had been put in the situations that I've been put in. But anyway, I've, for the last 3 years, 2.5, 3 years, lived on a cattle ranch where we breed and maintain grass-fed cattle. It's all organic. None of our cattle are in, well, unless they get sick, they're not injected with any kind of antibiotics. Sometimes in the winter time, we get calves that get coughs and we'll give them some penicillin, but you never ever, butcher an animal that has in the last 60 or 90 days, whatever, had, any kind of antibiotics injected. I'm not a vegan. I'm not a vegetarian like Ralph. I'm kind of feeling like I'm turning into a vegetarian because I'm so much leaning more toward the plant-based diet, just because Ralph is always talking about the 7-day vegan challenge. And, you know, he's always saying it, 7-day vegan challenge, 7-day vegan challenge. So me and my husband, we tried it. We did the 7-day vegan challenge, and I'm not going to lie, it really wasn't much different from how we eat. I mean, if I made spaghetti, I just didn't put the meat in it. I put extra mushrooms or, you know, whatever. and it was really easy and we all really liked it and nobody had any problem with it. But I do like meat. I do like chicken. I like beef. I understand where, vegans, a lot of vegans, where they come from with the cruelty to the animals and the industrialized, meat system and all that. That, to me, I absolutely agree with you all on that, because holy cow, the videos are insane. The way the animals are treated are insane. I absolutely understand what Ralph means when he talks about how, you know, animals that are killed like that are not as, you know, good. Even being, you know, just living here on this cattle ranch, I've learned that before they kill a cow, they make it happy. They feed it. They make sure it's nice and happy and basically exuberant in life and chilled out. And then, like, just a snap of a light, it's done. That way the meat is not tense. The muscles don't tense up. There's no adrenalized feeling rushing through their bodies, which actually tends to ruin the meat. And so it's an instantaneous thing. It's what they call humane, but what is humane, really? I mean, really, everybody has their own opinion on that. I do eat my own, like I said, I do eat beef. I have cut down on my red meats, but I do eat my own grass-fed cattle. And in the last 2.5, 3 years, I have gotten so much healthier than I've ever been in my entire life. I owe a lot of it to listening to Ralph Smart and Sadhguru in the last 3 years, because of them, I stepped out of my car. I extended my comfort zone, like Ralph would say. I extended my comfort zone. And so this is what I'm working on right now. This video you're watching right now is an extension of my comfort zone. Because I do tend to be somewhat antisocial. Most people would call me antisocial, but I'm a heavy thinker. I like to think a lot, so I don't like to, you know, be in big crowds of people. My aunt, when I was very small, told my mother that I was an empath. She quickly saw signs in me that other people apparently didn't. My mom did. She noticed when I would say, "Somebody answer the phone," and the phone wasn't ringing, and then 2 seconds later the phone was ringing. Yeah, my mom would kind of like, "How did you know?" You know. But anyway, so I just wanted to introduce myself and let you kind of get to know me. There's nothing really special about me. I'm just a normal person. I do like to study aliens and extraterrestrial life. I have been studying with Dr. Greer and the SETI team. And watching all the documentaries and keeping up with all the new information, because I do believe in extraterrestrial life, and And I'm sure a lot of people right now are going, don't stop. You don't want to watch this video anymore. But I do believe that they're out there. I do believe that if some intelligent life made us, then it made something else. Surely we couldn't be the only thing. I mean, look at us. As a society, we are basically animals. I don't know how things went from being what they were 200 years ago to what they are today. I don't know how much difference there is really in the history, except that I know that today, when I was growing up as a child, my parents literally, when our chores were done, our parents would say, go outside and play. And in today's world, I cannot just say, you know, when we lived in the city, I can now because we live, you know, 46 miles away from any city. But, you know, when I lived in Abilene, I literally would say, you know, let's go outside. Let's go outside and play. And I would sit on the porch and watch them play. I could not just say, go outside and play. Just get out of my hair, you know, quit being a nuisance. But now that we live 46 miles away from anybody, my closest neighbor, I think, is 2 miles away. And they're an elderly couple with a couple of dogs. And that's pretty much the closest person to me. The next closest person to me is my mother. She's 4 miles away, across about 5 different fields. If you were to just walk straight across the fields that way, you'd end up at my mom's front door. So I live kind of far out in the country, and, I love that the kids get to just like run and play and just like do whatever they want. Anyway, I'm going off on a tangent here. So anyway, 1 year ago, well, one year and a few months, I had been practicing meditation, I kept telling myself I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't really know how to do this. And I kept having this thought that I couldn't do this. Well, one day, I just decided I can do this. I can do this. Why not? You know, what's the worst that can happen? And so when I finally gave in and was like, I give up, you know, I stopped trying is what the key was. I stopped trying and I just sat still. And I thought it was a 10-minute meditation. It turned out to be a 3-hour meditation. And in that 3 hours, I was given a lot of information that I was not able to process that quickly, that fast. A human brain is very slow. It's like infant compared to whatever created us, because I could not process the information. The only thing that I could process at that very moment was that I was up somewhere outside of the atmosphere, looking down at the earth, and I realized in that second that we are all one thing, regardless of what we choose to believe. We are all one thing. Like, it's one thing. It's an earth, and we live on it. We are just one of the creatures that live on it, plain and simple. But in that moment, it gave me some clarity. And in that moment is what changed my entire perspective of life. When I woke up out of that meditation, I no longer saw my children as my children. They are children, and I have been blessed enough to have the chance to teach them and raise them up to a certain age, and then they're no longer even, you know, half the time they disappear across the country or across the world, you know. So I never, after that, I looked at my children as humans, just humans, different people. They were a part of me. I was just a gateway for them to get here, basically. I also stopped caring about a lot of things that I had previously cared about. A lot of it being superficial things like having my nails done or, you know, putting on makeup every morning, certain things that I had become kind of superficial about me, just kind of dropped off. I just kind of let it go and was like, you know, why waste my time? I could be out, you know, smelling wildflowers, and instead I'm in here worrying about paperwork, you know, or worrying about how I'm going to file my taxes or who I'm going to file with, or, you know, how I'm going to, when I'm going to get my paycheck and how I'm going to get all my bills paid and what order they're going to be paid in. My mind was a scatterbrained block of thoughts, and that's pretty much, I think a lot of people suffer from that. I really do, because I see a lot of people doing the same things that I did. And now, since I opened up my seven chakras and experienced something other than, I want to say outside of myself, but I truly believe that it was inside of myself. I kind of found out who I was, and I kind of learned a lot about myself that I didn't know, and I became less superficial. I became a lot more generous, a lot more thankful, very thankful for everything, because I've been blessed beyond belief. I never in my life expected to have the things that I have and to be able to do the things that I do. And it was all because of just simply asking for help, you know, ask those who ask not have not. So, anyway, I'm going to let you guys go. Basically, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. I'm here. Feel free to subscribe. I don't really know. I don't really know what else to talk about. I don't really have anything else to say, I don't think. But anyway, I will do other videos, and I will be back. See you later. Peace out, guys.